Are the loyal bears and other assorted lackeys assembled?
Yes, my most honored general.
Loyal bears and other assorted lackeys. Sergeant?
Yes, my glorious leader?
Where are the loyal bears and other assorted lackeys?
That's all that's left, general.
What? Seeing as the fur fighters have depleted my forces, I think it only fair that they contribute to their replacement.
What forebear have to wear impractical green rubber leotard in jungle conditions?
Little bear, be quiet. Big boss say is good for marketing.
Is everyone here? Good. Remaining loyal bears, I welcome you to the lost city of Anatat Tatanatat. This ruin, the stones, the earth, the very air we breathe, is charged with a raw and potent mystical power. Upon the arrival of the impending hurricane, I shall open a portal to the place where all bad bears go and raise an army of the undead. To perform this feat of magic, I will require the assistance of the delightful Winifred and her young pup.
I won't be helping you with anything, you big bully.
Unfortunately for you, my dear, your consent is not an issue. A pity, though. I shall miss you. You're the only one around here who ever got my jokes. Oh well, we all have to make sacrifices.
Okay, welcome to the penultimate world for this game. I didn't feel the need to have a little bit of an intro there just because I kind of thought, well, I'm just going to fade out anyway, so I may as well just be quiet for the entire part. But yes, penultimate world, City of Fear, or Anatat Tatanatat as it's less eloquently known. So to begin with, as with every opening world, what we'll do is just go around and find the 10 tokens that are in this opening hub world here. Pretty trivial stuff at this point. I must say I like the music for this background world. This and the final world, it definitely has pretty good music for it. So anyway, for the first world, unfortunately, unlike the first few worlds where you could basically collect the tokens for the opening world without really triggering anything, in this world you kind of have to find the tokens that are right outside. So seeing as how I'm probably going to end up triggering them for more or less all of the levels here, I may as well just show where they're all located. The first world that we're going to be going, or the first level rather, that we're going into is the Jungle of Despair, which is hidden behind this somewhat out of place sand pile that was there. But before we get there, we need to make another tour up to the right here. Bear here before we collect another two tokens right in front of the second level for this world, which will be the Temple of Gloom. and then move on further to the right around here, taking care of another bear just so that it doesn't shoot us as we're trying to run away from it. And we hook round to the left here where we find the third world, or the third world, the third level. This, pedestal, podium area that is just behind me at the moment. It doesn't look like much, and it kind of looks a little bit like it's supposed to be here with the whole scenery and everything. However, this is actually the third level called The Bad Place, which, as no doubt you heard Viggo was talking about, is the place where all the bad bears go. So we'll be coming back there soon enough. But before we do that, and that's where it is there, I will finally show right now where the boss fight for this world is. And that is saving Winnie and May. And I don't think I can get close to these tokens without the victory thing. Yep. So through that crack there, you can go in as anyone, but obviously Winnie and May, what they've decided to do for this world and what makes it a little bit unique is the fact they've combined two partners together, with some interesting results. Not physically, of course, it's not as if they've got one amalgamation, that'd be a bit horrible, a bit like morbid for a somewhat kids game, but if you've never seen it before, it's quite interesting, but we'll be getting there in quite a little bit's time. Rufus telepoint there if you need it, but that's all the tokens for this hub world, two outside each world, or two, I keep saying world, two outside each level, with the boss fight included, and two right at the start. So like I was saying, I'll basically make my way all the way back to the start and do the Jungle of Despair. I guess I should probably point out how many babies you need to enter saving Winnie and May. Again, off the top of my head, I don't know, so I'm going to, like with the past couple of videos, I'm going to make a guess and say, off the top of my head without actually even looking at it before, I'm going to say like 95. Seems a reasonable number considering that there's 125 within the game, and it would be, I think, a bit unfair to expect you to collect every single baby or even anywhere near that, but I think 95 would allow you to miss quite a few babies from each level and still be able to progress through the level. So I'm going to go with 95 and probably put at the top right now how many babies you need. But with that done, we will make our way into the Jungle of Despair. Now, to begin with, for this level, you can, it is possible if you want, it is possible to start the level as Rufus. I'll point out why in a second. You can start as Rufus, but I've kind of found that it's not entirely necessary. It'll let you do a certain part of the level that's coming up a bit more quickly than you usually would, but there's really no like desperate reason to do it. Take care of these guys here. So as you saw right at the start of the level, there was a total of 8 tokens and another 4 on this first beach area here behind these rocks. Now, just for the sake of completeness, I'll show off what's here. As you can quite clearly see, it's another ye olde bomb that's comically oversized for what it's probably intended for. But as you see, there's nothing about it at the moment that's inherently strange. A cobalt iridium hydrogen bomb, which might be a real thing. Certainly hydrogen bombs are a real thing. I'm not sure about the cobalt iridium part though, although that could be the container, but probably not. what do I know about making bombs? Anyway, with the 12 tokens there, we'll be coming back to that, I should probably say. That's going to be important a little bit later into the level. But with that done, get another 3 tokens around the corner here, another bear, a whole stash of plasma blaster ammo in that cave if you need it. I think I was running a bit low. Yep, back up to snuff again. And then around this corner, and we have another 4 tokens that are on this second beach area here. But again, another couple of bears, so we'll just take care of them first. Now there are 2 lobsters in the water. I've only triggered one, but you might be able to see just at the back there, it's hiding underwater. Just need to wait for it to come out of the water before you can do some damage. There we go. So this is basically why you can potentially use Rufus at the start of the level before you even come in, and it's for this Rufus mound at the back here. If you burrow into this, it takes you over to that island there. Now you would think, why not just swim over? Turns out the current is, unlike what the speed of the water seems to be showing you, it's apparently just too fast enough for us to like be able to swim over, so we're kind of stuck on this island here unless you use Rufus. There is another way to get into it, and it involves that little temple part at the back there, but more on that later. We will be coming back here fairly shortly. And I would suggest that you transform into Bungalow if you haven't already. I would go back to that telepoint and transform into Bungalow, because he'll become pretty useful in about a few seconds time. But we need to take care of all these bears first before we progress any further. I think we could probably leave that guy. Take him out. So again, you'll want Bungalow since he'll be the only one that's able to reach up here. And then you have another crocodile that comes out of nowhere. And we entered this room with another death trap, really, in all honesty. We have what I at first thought was quicksand, but to be honest, I don't think you can even describe this as quicksand, because that would imply that you could sink slowly into it. Hopefully this enemy demonstrates there. Yep, there you go. As soon as you swim straight into the center, you get sucked down with so much speed and force that you're pretty much killed instantly. So you would obviously be thinking, well, we're just going to jump around these platforms and get a baby. Nope, we are totally going to dive headfirst into this here. As much as you might think that's a crazy idea, it unfortunately holds a Rico baby on the other side once we're done with everything. So yeah, we're kind of, the first time I did this, I really didn't want to do it, to be honest, because it's bringing back, it's water in disguise, and it's water that can kill you. This definitely can kill you, unlike the rest of the the rest of the water that I've dealt with in the rest of this game. Like, this one physically actually can kill you. However, I've done it in practice, so I know where I'm going now. If you treat the back wall here as 12 o'clock, we are aiming, or like we're wanting to aim for 6 o'clock, and it's pretty much directly below us. There's like a chunk of earth that's been carved out of the wall, and it's that hole that you're going to want to swim through. Now, you can, the first time that I practiced this, you can jump off at about 11 o'clock and then swim around the back wall to 3 o'clock, 5 o'clock, and then you can go into the hole at the bottom there. It is also possible, if you fall down here, again, it doesn't do a great job just with the natural colour of this torrent here. It doesn't do a great job of highlighting it, but you'll want to try and swim as far down as quickly as possible. and the hole should present itself, because you're constantly going to be sucked in towards it. Even though it's going down the way, you're just going to get a tidal force that's trying to pull you in. So if you try and, like, if you kind of like idle around, you'll feel yourself naturally being dragged into the center, and then as soon as you're right in the eye of the storm, you're just going to get shoved right down, and you kind of get a little bit of a sideways action there as well. I don't know if that was like a little bit of a glitch or a bug that was left in that wasn't tested properly, but you don't need to worry about that. As long as you don't get caught in the absolute center, you should be able to swim away from pretty much anything, and then once you've done, you can just climb up and then get the Rico baby here. And lo and behold, we come back out to the starting area that I was talking about with the beach here, and you'll just want to jump off here, where we find this hut and a slightly grizzled veteran bear. So let's go and talk to him and see what he has to say.
Me recognize you, you fur fighter. Me not want to fight. Little fur fighter puppy tell I war is finished many year. Me just want to go home now. Me build raft, but cannot finish. Help I, and me give puppy back.
Don't trust him. He is a bear. We should probably kill him, but unfortunately, bullets.
You not get puppy.
Yeah, I know. I'm just a Jesus Christ, raft. Man. I'm just about to finish. Start it even. Anyway. So to begin, if we take a look at this poor excuse for a boat, it's missing a sail in order to give it power, like to use the wind currents, and it's kind of, or it is missing a rudder at the back to give it some sort of steering. Now, the rudder, since I'm as Rico, I'll basically start off by showing you where the, the rudder is. It's not, again, not incredibly clear. And I should probably point out as well, there's quite a lot of force that's pressing you back, similar to the start of the island, like trying to swim over here. I'm actually finding it quite difficult to fight against these waves at the moment, so I'm just coming around the back of the boat here and I should make it back on. Now, yes, I have it in my notes here that when you're facing out to the sea, which is approximately that direction, the rudder is in a tunnel that's underwater facing 11 o'clock, so it should be roughly down here, which is why I was diving in and trying to find it, but I can't seem to see it for some reason, and I don't want to swim too far down the sea because then you kind of get carried away, and then even Rico can't swim back even if you go underwater. Might actually be a little bit further at the back here. I guess I was looking at a different part of the island. It must have been, yeah, that's what it was. It was that part of the island that I counted as 12 o'clock, that's why it wasn't appearing. Should have noticed this massive hole at the back here, but yeah, so down this somewhat oppressing, somewhat scary looking hole with like red and black all along the walls, it's not the most inviting of places certainly, but you want to dive headfirst in here, and then as soon as you see this big open chamber here, you'll basically just want to swim up as quickly as you can, and then this will take you into this open room here. You get to refill on pistol ammo and health if you need it to find the raft rudder, and then once that's done, it's just a case of diving back down and doing the entire thing in reverse again. So with the raft rudder in our possessions, the only thing that needs to be found now is the sail, which as it turns out is a lot closer to the bear than you would expect. It's actually on top of one of these palm trees here. You would think if he was that desperate to get off the island, he would probably have a shake at trying to like get the sail out of one of these trees, but he's just too lazy for that, apparently. So transform into Juliet and find the tree that looks slightly different coloured from everything else. It's a lot brighter, and you'll see that there's scratch marks along the side of it. It's very well camouflaged, but you use these scratch marks to climb up here, and then kind of sight unseen you have to do a dive back the way to land onto this leaf here, and then you can jump up here and get the sail. And with that we can dive back off again and these items in.
Thank you, fur fighter. Me go home now.
Wouldn't be me sailing on that boat, that's for sure. There's more holes in that than Swiss cheese. But regardless, it lets us get the Rufus baby, so we'll just transform into him now. That's us. Cool, so the only thing in this entire starting area that we need to go back to, like I said earlier, was that bomb that's on the first beach island area. However, for the moment, there's really nothing else to do except to press forward. We'll get a little bit of a speed boost there with the current pushing us against the island, and come back through this area here. Unfortunate ambush there, get caught out a little bit. Thankfully, I believe that if you die doing this level, I don't think those guys ever come back again. You only have to deal with them once, which is thankful, I suppose. Get more guys in here. What I'll do is I'll start off here to the left. Now, there's tokens to the right there, however, I want to tackle this area to the left here first, since it's its own self-contained area. Once you've done everything in this part here, you never have to come back here again. Bear, or a couple of bears on the beach, I should say, and then there's a couple of flamethrower cows, and I might die, but hopefully. And a lobster, a few lobsters as well. Again, usually don't use the plasma beamer, upgraded version of the plasma blaster, but when you need to switch between weapons quickly, it always does the most upgraded version of that weapon, which I suppose is nice for the heavy machine gun and the auto shotgun, but when you're doing things like the plasma beamer and certain variations of the thermal gun towards the end, that it's not really that practical. But anyway, once you make it over to this island, there's a total of 6 tokens at the back here. This takes us up to 25, and then the next thing to do is to go inside this temple itself. Now you'll see, this will become a little bit important later, but you'll see that it does have a finite dimension to it, and it's relatively small for what it appears to be. However, Once we go in and turn right and then turn left into what you would expect to be a small room, we seem to be transported into another dimension. Definitely need health because there's quite a few of these roach things that are roaming around the area, so wanting to take them on with too little health. But yeah, we get transported into this otherworldly place. There are a total, in addition to the bears and the roaches, there's a total of 6 tokens in this initial area. And further, like deeper into the temple, there's another bungalow baby and a level dependent item that we have to find. So what we'll do first is just collect the tokens that are to the sides. As you would expect with somewhat symmetrical buildings, the token distribution is also symmetrical, so you've got 3 on the right hand side and 3 on the left hand side as well. I can make it up here. So transported to another place, and this is kind of backed up by what Bristol says.
Sorry, I've drawn a blank.
Now, I first thought that was to do with some puzzle solution, but I think it turns out that he himself is also detached from this world, or like he's been transported into like this world here and he can't actually think clearly because it's not off this world. That's the only somewhat logical explanation I can come up with. But as you heard, there was a couple of dragon things that were roaming around. I believe they're down the stairs here. But of course they're invisible, so it's kind of hard to see them until it's too late. So after that we come into this even bigger open area here. There are, by my count, a total of 18 tokens. There's 6 on these opening stairs here, again symmetrical design, so symmetrical tokens, 3 on each side. There's 3 under this pagoda mini temple thing here. Let's see if I can try and dodge the invisible dragon things. I just saw baby in the top left hand corner there. Let's collect the tokens and deal with these dragon things. It's kind of unfair that even if you're completely strafing to the side of them, where like their tongue isn't directly aiming at you, it can still do damage. And it's 10 damage a shot, it's not like a small amount. It'd certainly be a bit unfortunate if you get sort of like cornered by 2 of them and you just can't quickly deal with them or deal with them in enough time. But I believe there's only 2, so we should be good for the rest of this part here. Nope, there's 3. I tell a lie. Thankfully there's more than enough health for this part here. So the final set of tokens, with having collected 6 on the opening stairs, 3 under the pagoda and then 3 near the baby, the remaining 6 are on top here. Again, symmetrical distribution, so I just need Bungalow to jump up here. We can get the 3 that are on this side. And then once that's done, we can loop around this overhang here and get the 3 that are on the other side. And then completely fall off. I think we can jump back up there, so I'm gonna have to. Yes, I think we're gonna have to make it all the way around again, so I'll just fast forward through here. Right, let's try that again. Just a little bit overzealous with the side strafing there, I should be a bit more sensitive with it. Cool. So, 18 tokens for this area here. The only other item that you'll need to collect is on top of this pagoda here. Nice and shiny, so that lets you know that you have to collect it. And big run-up jump. And then just up these side areas here. $0.50 would be jealous. Although it doesn't have any like crystals or diamonds in it, so it's probably not as valuable. Anyway, the next thing is to take some more damage and then make our way back up, right back out to the second island again. Since again, that's everything that needs to be done has been done in this area here, so I'll just make my way back out to the beach.
No, it's no good, it's gone.
Oh well. Back through this temple here. So that's this entire beach area here done. So what we'll do now is take the right path that I ignored earlier, and I'll just collect the four tokens that were there to begin with. Also, in addition to the tokens, there's also this rather large set of wooden gates that we just can't get into for some reason. Now, what we need in order to get in, as the carvings might be able to show there, is we have a sculpture of what appears to be an elephant done in plant, from the looks of things. Don't know what that is, I think that's just another plant, but that's certainly an elephant, so we're going to be looking for something that kind of pays homage to that, and that will be coming up fairly shortly. For the moment though, we can go back through here, and instead of taking the left path now, we can now move to the right. Deal with some more loving bears, which reminds me, I'll collect the tokens that are in this upper area up here, three in total. There's also some more health and ammo, which I think I will try and save the health if at all possible, since there's quite a large fight that's coming up and I'll probably need it by the end of it. This does give us a good vantage point though, so I'll just describe the situation from up here. In addition to the three tokens that are in this upper area, there are nine tokens in this lower area down here. Now, we have this, grasshopper, roach-looking guy. He is kind of restricting access to this Chang baby here. We can't really rescue it until we do what is required of him, but I'll let him describe what he needs in a second. As soon as I get anywhere near these tiki hut looking things, bears are basically just going to keep pouring out of them, and the best way that I've found to deal with them, if you're quick off the draw, the best way to deal with them is to just keep lobbing grenades at them, since they'll run away, and if you can time it right, you can get them just as they're coming out of the huts themselves, so you're basically just lining up kill after kill. The problem, of course, is that you start getting surrounded if you're not good with your shots, but there's usually plenty of cover. It certainly goes on for quite a while, and then once you've taken care of those bears around there... oh dear, almost dead. I don't want to go back to the start of the level if at all possible. So I think what I'll do is I'll retreat for the moment and go get those super pet yums that are at the top. Hopefully I don't die. No, I'm good. It's fine. And it works especially well on this one here. Again, if you're good with the timing, don't suck at it like I do. Providing that you don't let them get out of the hut itself, you can easily chuck a grenade after grenade into there, and you won't have any problem because it's obviously an enclosed container and there's no destructible scenery within this game. It's nice and easy to quickly kill them. But again, 9 tokens, plenty of health, which is much needed. One's a little bit out of reach there. A couple to the right, another one there, and then 4 at the back here. Brings up 9 for a total of 65. So I may as well at this point talk to this guy here, see what he wants.
Fighter from afar, help me with my special potion, yes? Need ingredients, do I, for special potion? You bring me flower and skull, yes? Reward you, I will.
What they're trying to reference was probably funny at the time, but obviously with events that have happened, I think you know what I'm talking about, but...
Bring flower and skull, yes?
The skull we actually already have, that was the skull that we picked up earlier.
Skull of the Ancients you bring, recognize him do I. Go well in special mix will this, see?
But yeah, obviously current day it doesn't quite play as well as it would have done back in the when this game first came out. So this bridge, believe it or not, leads to the exit around that side of the temple there. There's another Juliet baby and a handful of tokens, but I'll be getting that later in the evening. Later in the evening. It is evening when I'm recording this, but later in the level is what I meant to say. So what I will do, since he requires the flower, is I will go and get into the means with which to actually do it. So to get through the gates we kind of need like a disguise, but it's not just any disguise. Oh no. We have a Trojan elephant, bitches. Oh Troy, you gonna pay now? And once you wheel it nearby, it gives the klaxon siren, the gate's parked, and then we charge inside to find that it's actually dead, quite literally. It's a tombstone area for some reason, with more carnivorous plants that want to kill us, but we'll be dodging those for the moment being, to pick up the flower that the guy was wanting. There is also, if memory serves me correctly, here we go, the flea part. Now obviously at this point we only have, if you've been following along, we did Chang in New York City, we had Rufus in Beaver Power, Juliet in Cape Canardo, and Dinotopolis we had Tweak. So that leaves Bungalow and Rico. Now, I obviously can't see any water here, and I'm kind of stalling for time. not entirely sure why I'm just explaining this, but it's obviously Bungalow that we need in order to jump here. You can leave this until the end. I think it's kind of 50-50 whether or not you want to do it now. You're not going to lose the flower or anything that I've got in the inventory at the moment. It obviously will respawn all of the enemies, so again, decision's kind of up to you. I think I'm just going to go and do it now and get it out of the road. But of course it's up to you if you want to leave it until the end of the level and then come all the way back and then fight your way through all the enemies again. It's really up to you. But I will try and get this done in a relatively short period of time. With this being the fifth of these flea puzzle shooty things, I don't really know if there's anything I can physically or literally talk about at this point. There's really not that much else to describe apart from the actual level itself, and this is, I would say, more similar to Chang's. It's quite expansive, there's quite a lot of areas to shoot about, you're not cramped or anything like that. But aside from that, and the fact that you're having to collect 7 instead of 5 or 6 or whatever it was, there's really nothing else to talk about. So I think, probably just for the sake of my voice, since there's still quite a lot of the level to go, Jungle of Despair that is, I think I'm just going to fade out at this point, and I'll probably just give you like a sped up version of these events. If you find these somewhat interesting and you want to see the entirety of it, then I apologise, but for me, like actually having to play it, there's not really that much else I think that I can talk about to fill the time, and I don't really think it's that interesting, from like a visual perspective at least, to like warrant going through the entirety of it all. So I think what I'm going to do is just stop talking and basically give you a sped up version. I'll probably slow down when I actually get to killing the fleas themselves, like the blood sucking ones, but apart from that I'm probably just going to speed up through the rest of it. So I will catch you on the other side of this fast forward, starting now.
Ah!
So yeah, quite easy once you know what the overall level looks like, with that being like a circle in the middle, one on the hair, and then three individual sections, each that had two in some sort of configuration. So I can appreciate why, like, what they're trying to do with each of the fleas. They're trying to tailor them to this specific characters. Although it's kind of hard, that's the thing, it's kind of hard to convey being able to jump high in flea form, especially when the flea can't really jump higher than anyone else. You know, it jumps as much as every other character that isn't Bungalow. But I can appreciate, like, especially with the Juliet level, they've done like a lot of platforming and stuff to try and convey her, like, acrobatic, able to climb up stuff aspect to her. But unfortunately, when everything starts to look like everything else, you kind of have to rely a lot more on memorization, basically, and being able to keep a bigger picture of what the level looks like, if that makes any sense. As you quite clearly saw there, no doubt I probably spent at least a good 2-3 times going around in circles. What a shot. That might be the best multi-kill I've done yet. That's up there with a couple that I've had previously. Anyway. Yeah, so like, you're kind of like relying on being able to remember where you've been already. Oh, they do spawn back. Oh, that's the second life of this level. So yeah, anyway, just to finish this thought, like, you kind of have to be able to see the bigger picture when it comes to the level, otherwise, like you saw there, it's quite easy to just run around in circles for like 5-10 minutes at a time, and that can start to get a wee bit, wear a bit thin after a while. But anyway, that's the flea puzzle thing done for City of Fear. So that only leaves Rico's in the next world, which we'll get to soon enough, but for the moment, back to this level here. With that done, I should probably point out as well, all these bears are probably going to spawn back as well. Yeah, so I'll just get through this area next, and then I suppose I could skip it, but no doubt I would probably get shot in the back if I was to try and progress much further, so I'll just try and quickly take out these guys here. I think I've waited a bit too long on the draw, so the grenade launcher isn't probably going to help at this point, but thankfully there's a ton of health dotted around here, so I don't have to worry too much about dying, as long as I don't get sloppy. Again, nice and easy to chuck it in again if you get ahead of the draw, but so anyway, what I will do now is toss in the flower, and we'll hear what he has to say.
Ah, flower you bring! Good! Go well in mix with this! Fighter from faraway land need to bring beetle to complete potion! You go now!
So if it wasn't, you know, if he wasn't not grateful enough for bringing us two somewhat hard to find artifacts, we now have to go and find him the right kind of beetle to add to his potion. So that's the second part to this quest that we'll have to start pretty much immediately now. On that note, it's now the right time to go exploring down this area here, picking up two tokens on the way. Now, this area contains a ridiculous number of enemies. A few bears to start off with here, but then as soon as you get much further in, you've got enemies that start coming in from behind, you've got the bears that spawn here. You've got another flamethrower cow that's up in the air. I do like the fedora on top of them though, it's a nice touch, it kind of helps to emphasise the theme in this world here. But anyway, we've got those guys, and then we've got another panda bear at the back here. And another flamethrower cow. Cool, so I think that's everything. It's certainly more than you would want to try and run past. I have tried it before, it doesn't end too well, unsurprisingly, but I don't know, maybe if you can stray from side to side, like zigzag your way along, you might have a better job at, or a better time at it. However, we approach this treehouse area here. Now, in this treehouse area, we will find one beetle that he's looking for, and we'll also find a Juliet baby that's on the first level. However, to get it to move, we kind of need to survey what this lift is connected to, and as it so turns out, it's stuck firmly to the behind of that elephant there. So if we were to give it a little quote-unquote encouragement, it'll start to march along. And I was kind of hoping Bristol would have came in before I started moving up the elevator, but let's see what he has to say.
Strong discipline's the best way to deal with uncooperative elephants.
Brawn over brains? Now that I can do.
Unfortunately, it's cost me 40 health, so it probably wasn't worth it to go through that bit of text. And doubly annoyingly, you kind of have to get the elephant to carry out the journey to its maximum fullest extent, which is basically to say shoot it 3 times, and then once it's right back at the start or at the furthest point that it can go, then it starts to go backwards. So we'll try that one again. So in this treehouse area here, again, I count 18 tokens across all the levels. I can't remember how many tokens there are for each level, but I think it's a fairly rough distribution. That is to say about 9 tokens on the first level and then roughly the same. Or there's probably about 6 on the second level and then 6 on the top, or, you know, roughly. However, obviously we're not as Juliet yet, so let's go back to the lift and ride up to the second elevator, or the second level in this elevator here. There we have even more rats to take care of, so I think what we'll do is I'll try freeze and then shooting them. Oh. There's the beetle. You can get lucky if you line up the shot right to have one of those guys, or like one of the rats, shoot the other rats and they just keep ploughing ahead regardless. It's almost as if it doesn't phase them at all, which I suppose fits, but the last level, and there's a little shortcut here, you can jump down here. I have to aim down at this point. The last level takes us up here. There's this annoying little part where this tree has taken up most of the ramp. Now I could risk jumping across there as Bungalow, but it should be fairly obvious to say at this point that if you fall from this height, you're pretty much toast, even if you have 100 health. So what I'm going to do is just try and gingerly make my way around, and there we go. Got another rat to take care of. There we go. So I will now transform into Juliet and make my way back down to the first level of the treehouse. Now again, since this is going to take us all the way back, I would rather try and time the jump so that I can basically, I don't have to ride the elevator back up again, I'll just jump off here. A fall from this height probably isn't going to do that much damage. It might do about 30 or 40 or so, but it's definitely more survivable than falling from the second or third levels. So with that done, the next step is to now proceed back to the grasshopper thing, roach. I again, still really don't know what you call them. They look fairly similar to the ones that you have to shoot. But it kind of looks a wee bit like a grasshopper as well, but I'm not entirely sure. Regardless, just head back to him now. And this should be the beetle that he's looking for.
From far away,
yes, yes, I know. I have it. Let me hand it in.
Beetle, you bring...
And done.
Bad fur fighter. Wrong type beetle is this. This beetle, bad juju. Special beetle you find. You bring, you go now.
Sigh. It's the wrong type of beetle, so we're gonna have to go find another type of beetle. So if we cross this bridge here. Now, just to spoil the surprise a little bit, when you reach the halfway point, this bridge is gonna snap in half. Thankfully, you don't take any fall damage. You kind of just get thrown into this pit here with a few of these rats. Just quickly take them out. But we also find another beetle. So that should be the one that he's looking for now. Another three tokens at the bottom here to bring us up to 88. Another flamethrower cow to do some damage to us. I should probably point out, only one of these bridges contains scratch marks. Like this one where we came from doesn't. However, you can still climb up these and make your way to the right, and then that'll take you around. However, we kind of don't want to go there just yet. There's still a few more things to do, such as another three tokens in this hollowed out tree area here, and this takes us back round down here, which is nice and convenient, so we'll hand this in. And done.
Another beetle! Wrong beetle this is!
Oh, what?
You go now! You not come back until correct beetle you have, yes?
He's weirdly specific for something that's going to probably get crushed up and get burned to death in that cauldron, but okay, we'll go with it. The last beetle can be found right at the start of the level. When I said that we would be coming back to that bomb that was on the island, like the very first beach area that we passed, the last beetle is nearby. So I'll try and make a runner and save a bunch of ammo. It's probably going to end poorly, I will admit, but it's a lot of ammo to have to spend in order to get back fighting sort of thing, so I'll take care of the ones that are essential like these guys here, but hopefully the rest of them should leave us alone if we get far enough away from them. That's the theory anyway. Or perhaps not. Right, so deal with those guys. So make a break here, and the bomb seems to have some new visitors now. So I'll try and talk to one of these guys, see what they're on about.
Pay homage to Holy Vessel of Boom Boom! Bomb!
The Inception Bomb before the Inception Bomb. If only Bizarre Creations knew. So we come round the back, and now the bomb becomes more interesting because we have a set of wires that we have to defuse, but you might be able to see inside there's also a beetle. And obviously by doing that you've went and triggered it, so now I'm on a time limit. The code is basically the colours on the book there, so yellow, blue, green and red. And as you expect, if you don't defuse it in time or you shoot the wrong wire, you get a blast of colossal proportions. However, by doing that correctly, you are able to successfully defuse the bomb, and you can jump inside and get another 3 tokens. And another beetle. So again, yellow, blue, green and red, and if you... I have it in my memory that when I messed up earlier as a child, I think the blast was pretty impressive, especially for the time. Like, it would easily take out... I don't know how, zoomed out it would actually show you, whether it was, the entire island being decimated or just the actual... this beach area itself, but it was pretty impressive at the time, but there's no reason to... deliberately fail just to show off something cool, but that's that pretty much done. So we'll just leave these guys to it, and they're just gonna keep uselessly praying away to something that's probably shouldn't have praise upon it, but yeah, anyway. With that done, I am looking ahead and there is 2 more babies to find, obviously, in the top right hand corner there. The Chang baby that is being somewhat held hostage, I suppose, by the grasshopper roach thing. That's one of them, but there is also another Juliet baby, like I was saying earlier, that's right at the end of the level. So I think I'll just stick as Juliet for the moment. I'll have to transform back into her, obviously. Which might require a trip back to that treehouse area, but for the moment, let's transform better back into Chang. And let's go hand in what should be the absolute final beetle.
Bad fur fighter! Wrong type beetle is this! This beetle, bad juju. Special beetle you find. You bring, you go now!
Well, we've brought every beetle back that we can possibly find on this island, and it's a bit unfortunate because you're supposed to get different dialogue which says that the type of beetle that is required is a special Viggo head beetle. And it just so happens on the back that he's actually a traitor, he's working for the enemy, so regardless of whether or not you actually want to complete this potion, which wouldn't get done anyway, or you just want to kill him, quick tap and that shoves him into the boiling liquid, which we probably, to be fair, we probably should have done to begin with and save this whole charade, but it wouldn't be a puzzle without that, I suppose. Now, you might be wondering why I'm going into this tunnel area, this little hut area here. I generally find that it's easier to jump from the side, regardless of what you might have just seen there. If you jump from the side here onto this plank, I find it to be easier than trying to jump up from that lower wooden ramp area, since there's a possibility that you might undershoot or overshoot it and end up falling into this liquid here, which probably will kill you. If I had to take a safe guess, I would say it's probably going to kill you. So with that, the last remaining thing is to go and transform into Juliet, and then we can make our way towards the end of the level. I can't remember off the top of my head if there is a Juliet telepoint near the exit to the level. So what I'll do is I'll just quickly go up here and then fast forward towards the exit of the part that we're interested in. Cool. So that brings us back to here. Now, unfortunately, it's rather unfortunate, since obviously this bridge is snapped, and if we were to take a running jump off of here, we would certainly die. So the best advice to offer, since we can't go back round to where that hole is and try and jump in there and work round here in reverse, is to kind of just try and batter off the sides of those things, and that might take a bit of your momentum off of like your overall fall. There's kind of nothing else that I can really say to do, unfortunately. Thankfully, there aren't that many enemies towards the end of this level. I think there's probably like three small bears, maybe a peacock, but that's pretty much the only thing that you can do, unfortunately. So that takes us round to here. Flamethrower count. Oh, two flamethrower counts. Okay, so, and another carnivorous plant, but we'll get to that in a minute. So, as you can see, nice big bottomless pit of death. This will, of course, kill you if you fall into it. However, we need to traverse across in order to get to safety, but the width of this platform is more than generous to get across, so there should be no problems. Now, there's three tokens around this part to the left, or to the right there. Oh, two roaches as well, excellent. Just what I need when I'm at low health. So, to actually get up there, if you try and jump straight ahead onto that platform, you'll run out of you'll run out of space basically, and you'll collide against the wall and then just fall down. The better way to approach it is to jump up to the left here, and if you get high enough up on this platform you should be able to make it across. However, the platform does protrude slightly away from the platform you're trying to jump onto, so it's trying to find the correct point that you're close enough to here, but obviously not too far away, otherwise you won't make it up, but you're trying to find enough height as well. It's kind of not the easiest jump to make. I think I remember halfway to three quarters being the right number, but Bungalow would, or I suppose even Tweak would, make a mockery of this jump and wouldn't have to attempt it multiple times, but sadly we need Juliet to be able to climb up and make it round here, so it's kind of just trial and error until it works. Okay, that's probably in my mind about 30 bajillion attempts, so at this point I'm going to say fuck it and move on, since this is just going to be more stuff for me to edit out later towards the end. Get away with not dying here. All I'll do is make a dive down here without getting hit. Now, this is where the next what you get for rushing it, Paul. I should say as well, like as you can see here, whenever you die, you basically, for some stupid reason, it shows that you get that cutscene of the grasshopper roach thing being pushed back into the, or pushed into the cauldron. However, obviously since that's already been done, it doesn't really affect you that much. Unfortunately, I believe, or maybe I've just gotten lucky, most of the enemies should respawn here. I have tried that, yeah, like I was saying, like at least easily 30 times, but I can't see why it isn't working, because you can't do it as anyone else. It has to be Juliet. She's the only one that can climb up this ladder thing here. You can't even try and time it correctly so that you could glide across this tweak, like you wouldn't even have enough elevation to do so. I just can't seem to figure out what the right angle was and like the right timing distance, but I know that that's definitely how you have to do it, because I tried numerous times to try and jump onto the part that was on the right, but it just didn't work for whatever reason, so there's nothing else that I can really say, unfortunately. It's kind of just a case of trial and error in the truest possible fashion of the word. I think what we'll do is, let's see if I could try and take out that flamethrower cow, but it seems to have disappeared. Maybe it's just underneath. Maybe it's from up here. You would not believe that. Jesus Christ. Right, okay. Moving on. Collect the 3 tokens here and probably get killed again. Since we've got more bears and roaches to deal with than I would like at this level of health, but it. Cool, so let's try that one again, but try it a bit more patiently and less reactionary. Right, should be safe now. So ultimately, the Juliet baby is up on that platform there. However, as you probably, or as you did clearly see, these very poorly disguised traps hide, like spear trap, or like these little spear trap things. These things don't actually kill you. It's kind of just like the bottomless pitfall that kills you. Oh my god. OMG. Anyway, let's pretend that didn't happen. Let's definitely not pretend, or let's definitely pretend that I'm not gonna have to run all this again. Ay ay ay. Must be because it's late at night. Must be. You have got to be kidding. This is not possible. I'm hitting the jump button at the right moment. This is getting embarrassing. Oh, dearie me. And that's doubly excellent, because now what I had planned to be a time-saving device has now went and cost me even more time since it's went and reset itself. So this, this is turning into an absolute embarrassment, a joke of a part. Everything was running so smoothly. Ah, dear me. I'm half deciding whether or not I should just delete all of the footage that shows me failing over and over again. But I think what I'm going to do is I'm just going to keep it in just for reminder's sake of what not to do. Unless, of course, it ends up making this video obscenely longer than it has to be. In which case, I'll probably take it out, but oh dear. It's just the enemies have resetting all the time. Like, it's no fun. Like, when you've already proven that you can, like, do this area, it just, you don't gain anything from having to do all this all over again. Right. So that plant should keep those guys entertained. So, first jump. Done. Second jump. There we go. Trigger that. Jump. There we go. Third jump. Fourth jump. Awesome. That's how it should have went the first time. Goodness knows why it didn't, but with that, you get another 3 tokens at the back here, and the last baby for this level, which is a Juliet baby. And with that, we just have to easily fall back off here. There's no way I'm trying to make those set of jumps again. And then just try and navigate around here, and hopefully not die. Take out this roach. And that is us done for the Jungle of Despair, which certainly lived up to its name towards the end, despite how well it was going at the start. However, let's put that all of that behind us. Again, certainly more than 35 minutes, seeing as how we had another flea puzzle, but of course you already know it at this point. It's an hour and 25 on my recordings, but of course that means nothing as I'm saying it. It's because you'll have seen it already on the YouTube video timeline. But anyway, 100 tokens, 6 babies. We have the same again for the Temple of Gloom, and then there is only one baby to rescue in the bad place, and then that is every single baby found. Still another, by my count, if I remember correctly, we should be at 1,690 tokens at this point. So there's another, or no, we should be at 1,700, shouldn't we? Since there's another 200 to find in this world, and then there's another 300 to find, or 310 if you include the hub world in the final part, for a total of 2,110. So we're almost done. We're getting dangerously close towards the end of this game. But anyway, I'll cut it off here since it's been going on for probably quite long enough at this point. Next up is the Temple of Gloom, where there are Indiana Jones references abound, but we'll get to that soon enough. See you then.